Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this free sales funnel guide, you're going to learn exactly how to put together an entire sales funnel from collecting emails to delivering your sales message and getting paid for $0. So make sure you check out the timestamp table of contents in the description to hop around this along with updates as we find new software to put together your sales funnels for free. So to do this, we're going to be using MailChimp, YouTube, and something called Wave Accounting. So with these three solutions, you're actually going to be able to put together everything you need for your first sales funnel for, of course, $0. Now, as we dive in here, this is not a replacement for real sales funnel software. This is just if you're on a very, very tight budget or you want to experiment with this whole online marketing thing before you invest too much cash. So let's go ahead, jump into our screen, and I'll walk you through the process of setting up your email list, putting together your landing page, your sales page, and of course, getting payments. So the very first thing is you can go ahead and go to MailChimp.com and set up a free account. I'm already inside a free demo account that we have here. So the first thing you're going to want to do is go to audiences and actually create a new audience. Now, because we've done so many YouTube tutorials with this demo account, we are actually maxed out on audiences, so my create new audience button has disappeared, but this is the page where you'll be able to create your audience. So once you've done that, you're ready to go to campaigns and create your landing page. Now I'll go click by click through how to create the sales page, and I'll show you the key elements of the landing page now. So if you want to just skip ahead to click by click, here's a timestamp to do that. Now here, what we're gonna do is I'm going to go ahead and click on a landing page that we've already created. And here's a quick preview of the landing page that we're going to be putting together. You can see you have your headline, a nice little image. You can use something called Canva. Link in the description to how to make awesome images in Canva. And then just a couple bullet points, and of course, that email address collection box. So to create your landing page, you'll come over here to Create Campaign, and then you'll click on Landing Page. You'll go ahead and give your landing page a name and then select the audience that you want the landing page to send new subscribers to. And then we enter our information and go ahead and click begin. And once you click begin, you'll be taken to a page that looks like this, where you'll be able to select your templates. Now, when it comes to creating your first landing page, I'm sure you've seen a lot of different types of landing pages, styles of landing pages, and very, very nice looking landing pages. When you're just starting, you don't need to get fancy. Keep it simple. So to do that, we're going to go ahead and select the Grow Your List template here, and then we'll go on to design. Now in design, we'll modify this just a little bit so that we create a headline and then use an image plus caption block to display whatever our opt-in offer is. So if you're doing a PDF guide or you're going to be doing some sort of video, this is where you could put a preview of that here. You just want it to be an image. We don't want to actually put a video on this page for split testing, for testing purposes. And then at the very bottom, you'll be able to drop in your contact form. Here, I'm just asking for the email. And if I pull out, you can see here that there are a couple of different elements. It's not a complete drag and drop editor, right? But remember, you're getting this 100% free. And all of these elements will allow you to put together your landing page and your sales page. So once you've put together this landing page, you can go ahead and click save and publish. And our landing page here is good to go. Now, the second page you need to put together is your sales page. And this is the page that's going to show up right after your landing page. So this is where we're going to go click by click through the editor for the first time. So I'm going to go back over to campaigns here and click on create new campaign. And for our sales page, I'm going to click on landing page again. So this is kind of hacking MailChimp a little bit because it's not designed to do this. But as long as you can create a web page, we can make a sales page. So we'll give our landing page, sales page a name, go ahead and select the email list. Just make sure it's the same email list as the one you selected the first time, because sometimes MailChimp doesn't allow you to go back and change it in the free version. So we'll go ahead and click on begin, and we'll be taken to the exact same page where we can choose our template. I'm going to choose the exact same template to keep it nice and simple, grow your list, and then we are ready to start making our sales page. So in this particular instance, I'm going to be making a video sales letter page. So what I want to do is go ahead and click and drag this up here, give it a headline, and then we'll go ahead and click save, and we want to drop in our video. So they actually have a video element, so we'll click and drag it up here, and this is where we're going to put our YouTube URL. For example purposes, I'm just going to grab the URL of this one and then go back to editing our page. And then here's where we can drop in our video URL. Something I've had trouble with is using Vimeo, but if you're putting together something for free, all you need to do is put your sales video on YouTube as unlisted. Don't do private because private won't work, but put it as unlisted and then you can embed it on this page. Now, of course, if you have a text-based sales letter or you have a sales letter that's just going to be a series of images, you can do that on this page as well. So I'm going to delete the logo. And of course, if we want people to buy after they've watched the training or read through our sales message, so if this was our sales letter, we could go ahead and copy. I'm just gonna copy a couple times so you can see. You can put as much text as you want on this page. So if we were doing a written sales letter, here would be all of our text, but we're not doing that. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that content block. And we're going to add a button because we need a buy now button. We need people to have the ability to go to our shopping cart. So we don't have our shopping cart URL yet, but we can change the style. So I'm going to go to settings and make this full width so it's nice and easy to see and not really mess with this other than change the color to a red or an orange. Probably do better than that, but we're going fast here. So let's go ahead and click save and we'll remove the content block for an email opt-in because they've already opted in. So now let's go ahead and preview our sales page here. And you can see that we have our headline, we have the video, and we have a buy now link. This is all we need for our sales page. So I'll go ahead and exit out of that and I will click save and close because we need to publish this to get the URL. So on this next page, we'll go ahead and add the URL. We're not gonna do a custom URL because that requires us to pay something. We want to do this for free. So I'm just going to come up here and copy the name of the sales page and make that the URL and click on save because we need this URL for our landing page. So once we've set our URL, we need to come up here and give it a page title and then publish will appear here. Apologies for the jump cut. Completely forgot about adding a page title. High five, it is live. So if we click on it now, you'll see that we have a live sales page with our headline, our video, and a buy now button that doesn't actually work. But we want to capture this URL and we're gonna go back into MailChimp and edit our landing page. So now that we have our sales page, we have our landing page, we need to tell MailChimp that whenever someone enters their name and email on our landing page, we want to send them directly to our sales page. So that's what we're going to do right now that our sales page is live. So we'll come back in here. We can see our landing page. I'm just going to go ahead and click on edit, and then we'll click on edit design. So coming in here to editing the design, and we're going to scroll down here to our opt-in form under content. We'll scroll down and instead of confirmation message, we can send them to a web address and we can paste it in here. And it looks like they recently updated because we can actually just select a landing page now. So I guess you don't have to copy that URL. We could skip that step now. And go ahead and click on landing page and we'll choose our YouTube sales page one and we'll click save and close. So now what's happening after I click publish, we can drive traffic to our landing page and then as soon as they enter their name and email, they'll automatically be sent over to the sales page. Now, of course, on the sales page, we still need to set up our shopping cart. And to do that, we're actually going to be using something called Wave Checkout. So Wave Accounting is a free accounting software, and they recently released a feature that allows you to collect credit card payments directly through their payment processor. So you're going to pay a higher fee than what you typically see on PayPal and Stripe, but it gives you it takes care of everything for you, and you don't have to put any money into it in order for it to work. So to do this, you'll go to waveaccounting.com, you'll create a free account, and then you'll be able to click on sales and checkouts, and you'll be able to create a checkout form. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new one here, and let's say this is just a YouTube ads course. And we'll give it a name, a price, and then a success message. So here in this success message, you can set it up so that you either put a link directly to what they just purchased right in this message that pops up, or you can use a free tool called Zapier to connect Wave with MailChimp, you'd set up a separate audience, and then whenever someone fills out this checkout form, they'll automatically be added to another sequence in MailChimp, and then MailChimp will send them the information that they need. So you can do it both ways. Here we're just going to keep it simple and do a confirmation message, and we'll go ahead, save, and turn on, and now we'll be able to preview what our shopping cart looks like. So you can see here, it's very basic, very simple. It's on their server, so you don't have to worry about SSL or collecting credit card information or all that fun stuff. They take care of it, but we do want that URL because we need to go back to our sales page and update the buy now link. So now that we've copied our URL, we can go back to our sales page under campaigns, click the little drop down here to edit it, and we'll go into edit the design, and we'll just update the link of the buy now button. Scroll down here, click on buy now, web address, there we go. Save and close, save and publish. And let's go ahead and just make sure that it is actually working. So we'll go to a preview of our live sales page here. And when we click on buy now, all of a sudden we'll be taken to the Wave Apps page where someone can enter their payment information in order to purchase. So just as a quick summary, we've created a landing page where we can collect their email, and then once they enter their name and once they enter their email address, they'll go ahead and be taken to this page. And then in your email sequences, you can send them back to this page. Of course, MailChimp has a tremendous amount of restrictions on automation now with their free plan, but at least you can send emails for free. And so your welcome email that you can send automatically, and then your landing page, of course, confirmation URL will both send people to your sales page. And then on your sales page, you can have a buy now button. And when people click that, they'll be taken to your checkout page where you can collect payments, and you can either have an email go out from MailChimp telling them where to get their stuff or how to get started working with you, or you can have a success message pop up right there with links to what they need to do next. So thank you so much for watching. I sincerely hope you got some value out of this video. Make sure you check out the links in the description if you're curious about how to set up a membership site for free, if that's ultimately what you want your sales funnel to be able to do, along with some other tutorials and ideas on how to recreate this funnel using a combination of MailChimp and Google Sites if you don't want everything on MailChimp for some reason. So go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe for more sales funnel building tutorials just like this one, and until the next video, keep building the business you love.